Good evening. I'm Nicholas Hoare for Vermont PBS. This is a story by a wonderful Australian author called Bob Graham, and it's called Rose Meets Mr. Wintergarten. Let's see what happens. First of all, take a look at that illustration. Here's a nice little friendly house, and there's a big, nasty, scary house, and one is next door to the other. What's going to happen, do you think? Let's see. Rose meets Mr. Wintergarten. There's the for sale sign, and it's marked sold. The morning the Summers family moved into their new house, they felt at home. Faith and Rose put up their pictures. Baby Blossom watched. Mr. and Mrs. Summers planted pansies, petunias, daisies, and geraniums. Their garden was a carpet of flowers, all before the sun went down. They were great gardeners. Every morning from the roof of their house, the Summerses watched the sun come up. The sun never touched the house next door. Next door, everything bristled. That means it was sharp. Next door lived Mr. Wintergarten. There were stories in the street about Mr. Wintergarten. "He's mean," said Emily. "And horrible," said Arthur. "He's got a dog like a wolf," said Naomi. "And a saltwater crocodile." "They say he rides on his crocodile at night," said Emily. "And gets ya," Arthur shrieked. "I don't believe you," said Rose. "Anyway, don't frighten Blossom." "My dad lost his football over there when he was a boy," said Emily. "You can just see it through the prickles, old and flat as a pancake." "No one ever goes in there," said Arthur, "in case Mr. Wintergarten eats people." "If your ball ever goes over," said Naomi, "forget it." And just then, Rose's ball went straight over Mr. Wintergarten's fence. Rose went to tell her mum. "Well, honey bunch," mum said, "you can get your ball back. Why don't you just go and ask him?" "Because he eats kids," said Rose. "We'll take him some cookies instead," said mum. "And maybe some flowers." Mr. Wintergarten's front gate had not been opened for years. Rose heaved and pushed. The gate groaned and squeaked. Then, slowly it swung open. Rose could see that there was a dog, big as a wolf. "But I don't see any crocodile," she said. "I should hope not," said Mum, and threw the dog a cookie. Rose knocked at Mr. Wintergarten's door.
"Who the devil's that?"
shouted a voice from inside. "It's me," said Rose, and tiptoed in. "What do you want?" said Mr. Wintergarten. "I'm Rose Summers from next door. I've come to ask for my ball back." She twisted her fingers in her handkerchief. "I've brought some flowers and cookies from my mum." Mr. Wintergarten glared at her. His dinner was cold, gray, and uninviting, with gristle floating in it and mosquitoes breeding on top. But Rose could see that he wasn't eating children. "Please, may I look for my ball?" she asked.
"No,"
growled Mr. Wintergarten. "Go away." But when Rose had gone, Mr. Wintergarten slowly pushed back his chair and did something he hadn't done in years. Mr. Wintergarten opened his curtains. He sat on his front step in the sun. No one has ever asked for their ball back, he said to himself, or brought cookies. He saw Rose's ball and thoughtfully pushed it with his toe. Next, he made some darting movements that made his coattails fly in the sun. And then Mr. Wintergarten kicked the ball. Right back over the fence. Great kick, said Rose.
Nice catch, said Mr. Wintergarten. Would you mind throwing back my slipper?
He added. Catch, Mr. Wintergarten, said Rose, throwing back the slipper.
Good throw, Rose, said Mr. Wintergarten. Let's play again tomorrow.
And this is a picture of the same two houses. This one is now full of light. The fence has come down, all the wire is gone, the moving truck is taking it away, and Mr. Wintergarten, look, is playing with all his brand new friends. And that is the story of Rose Meets Mr. Wintergarten. And I'm sure Pippin would agree with me that it is fun from start to finish. And on that Australian note, good night.